It was a good movie. Welcome back to the Sonic, guys. Sonic.
The Sonic. So, this is what I want to talk about in this episode.
Talk to me.
Suicide Squad.
Ah.
Have you seen it? It came out a few days ago. I saw it on the release night or whatever.
Yeah.
And I was pumped, man. I don't even usually like superhero movies, but I was pumped.
Yeah.
And dude, it was the best movie I've ever seen, honestly. I loved it so much.
Shut your mouth.
Dude, it was so good. I loved it so much.
Dude.
I loved the whole movie. The whole movie was good. It was good movie.
I love how the lie starts to crumble around itself.
It doesn't crumble. Dude. Good. Good movie, good.
Good movie.
Dude, it was such a piece of shit.
Oh, man.
Dude, that was too mean. It was someone's obviously creative work. I was just... I've been a bit facetious when I say that, because it actually started... Like, the start was pretty good, I thought. Like, you know, not the most, Look, it wasn't, like, the start of a movie that would blow your mind, but I was pretty excited when it started. Like, I was with it. And then...
Until when?
Until... After, like, I think... The first, like, 15 minutes.
Dude, how was Jared Leto?
He was pretty bad.
Yeah.
I think some people, like, opinions I've seen range from he was, like, adequate, to he was pretty bad, to he was actually surprisingly good.
Yeah.
And I kind of sit in the, like, it was a pretty lame Joker. Like, it was such a trite, you know what I mean? Like, he was a caricature.
Yeah, sure.
And, like, I know Joker
That's a good way to put it.
Like, it is kind of like he was lifted straight out of a cartoon. And Jared Leto was like, what does a crazy guy do?
Sure.
And, like, I don't know. That's what it felt like.
Yeah, no.
And it was so outrageous that it wasn't outrageous.
Sure.
Like, whereas Heath Ledger's Joker was very human.
Yeah.
Like,
I'm not sure if it was... Because we had a conversation the other night about it, Davey.
Yeah.
I think... I'm not sure if it was you that said it or someone else said it.
Yeah.
But the way you put it just then was great. Like, it's just trying to be too... great. I think it had a lot of pressure on it. That's what I keep reading is, like...
Yeah.
Had a lot of pressure on it because Batman vs. Superman wasn't very good.
Oh, yeah.
But still fell over. Man, why can't DC make good films?
I don't know, man.
They have all the content.
Dude, who
the
made...
characters, the backstory.
Who made the Dark Knight movies? Like, was that...
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
They were awesome.
Nolan. What are you feeling?
But, like... that's the thing. Like, so I didn't watch Batman vs. Superman.
Yeah.
I wasn't really... I'm not really into superhero movies, so I need to be excited about it before I watch it.
It just seems like... And this is kind of a broad thing to say. And this is only, from watching Batman vs. Superman, and then hearing reports on Suicide Squad, is that they're putting the focus on the wrong things.
Right.
So Batman vs. Superman was, felt like he was just trying to be dark for the sake of being this dark kind of superhero movie.
Yeah, okay.
I think I've said this before, but it was like they were trying to prove a point, but the point didn't need to be made. That's how it kind of explained Batman vs. Superman. It was like 2 hours of someone trying to say something to you that doesn't need to be said.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's... Yeah,
it's like they're answering a question no one asked.
Dude, perfect way to put it. Perfect.
That's
a really good way to put it, man.
But, like, I think the problem for me with Suicide Squad was the story was so weak.
Sure.
The bits with the Joker in it didn't need to be in the movie. It added almost nothing.
Zero plot, yeah.
To the plot. And that was so short-lived anyway. The acting was, like, fairly bad, just generally.
How was Margot Robbie?
She wasn't great. She was, like, she was just full of, like, weird, like, half-jokes.
Oh, she was.
And, like, very, like... There's one that stood out to me that was, they're in a hangar. Or they're in a plane or something, actually. And, she offers to shake. What is a samurai? There's a samurai girl. I can't remember what her name is, but...
Katana?
Yeah, I don't know. Probably. Actually, I have no idea, but...
she has a sword.
And she's like, yeah, she has a sword, and, like, Margot Robbie is like, nice to meet you. And you have, like, this... Well, nice perfume. Like, what is it? The stench of death?
Right.
And it's like, it's not funny. It wasn't a... it's not a funny joke. Like...
Right.
One, there's too many syllables for it to be funny. Like... Yeah. It wasn't a sharp punchline, but also, it's very trite.
Oh, god dang it.
The word, perhaps, that I'm looking for is kitsch. The whole movie felt very kitsch. It felt like your grandmother's porcelain, like, you know, the porcelain plates that old people have in their house that you're not allowed to use that are in a glass cabinet. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I think so.
The chinaware, the good chinaware that no one can use. Anyway.
Yeah, sure. I know what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
I think I'm struggling to get my head around what the analogy means.
I guess, like, it's... let me simplify it. It's lame. Okay. It's like... It feels lame. It feels, like, silly and but not in a funny, jovial way.
Yeah. I like the word jovial.
Jovial?
Yeah.
And I just think, like... And, like, there's so many things that, like, character development... They literally introduce the character. Like, they spend all this time doing the backstories for all these characters.
Yeah.
And then they're like, and this guy. But he just turns up randomly.
Oh, yeah.
And they just introduce him. As soon as you see him, he's like, well, you know... I think everyone knew. Like, he's a guy who's gonna die.
Right.
And, like, there are other weird things, like, there's this other, the Mexican, like, gang lord fire guy.
Yeah.
He's just like, I do nothing throughout the whole movie until the end where I turn into, like, this fire god thing.
Wait, he actually says that?
No, he turns into this thing that, I don't know. Sorry, spoiler alert. Whatever. it's just
we'll title this episode Suicide Squad
spoilers
or something. Yeah.
By the time this comes out, it'll be fine. Look, all in all, it wasn't even entertaining. Like, the fight scenes weren't even entertaining.
How's Will Smith?
He's probably like, I actually really like Will Smith as an actor. But there's these awkward moments in the movie as well where, like, you can tell originally they were going for, like, some real sad, pensive moment, but they cut it from the film.
Oh, right.
So, like, there's this one moment where Will Smith was looking off in the distance with tears in his eyes, but, like, only for, like, half a second. And like, then it cuts to the next scene, but in such a way that makes you think, like, the director wanted to stay... on Will for a while and, like,
right.
really push that emotion. But instead, it's like he looks to the camera or towards the camera with, like, glassy eyes and then cut. And then,
right.
Like, really quickly. So you probably would have missed that.
Because his character has, I think he had a daughter, right? Deadshot.
Yeah.
It's all about his daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Look. It was a letdown of a movie.
Yeah, man.
I don't think.
Well, it's got the new world record for ticket sales.
Let's see if it can sustain it.
Oh, yes. All right. If I get this emerald,
then this is it. This is the session. This is the session done. We can all go to bed.
Yeah, we can all go to bed. We get super sanic.
Super sanicked. We will... What happens if you get all the coins in this? You just end up with more coins?
You get a continue.
Oh.
Which would be helpful for us.
We do need that.
Yeah.
We need more continues, you know? Little man lives. They're very helpful.
Man lives?
Man lives.
Yeah. Boom, 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 boom. So this is the tricky part. Oh, this is nice.
Oh, you're doing really well, man.
Thanks, man. Pretty nervous, actually.
I don't know how you looked at it, to be honest.
It's pretty brutal here.
Oh, yeah, it's very brutal.
Don't know where to go. Let's go this way.
So yeah, guys, if you were thinking about Suicide Squad and seeing it in the movies, I reckon you should still see it if you really want to. But if you're on the fence, or if you're anything like me and don't particularly enjoy superhero movies, then maybe give it a miss. But like, give it a hard miss. Like, don't even wait for it to come out on DVD.
A hard miss.
Like, just completely miss it. Like, just let it go.
Shit me to this, okay.
Imagine if, like, Will Smith was, like, one of the mega fans of our Let's Play, and I just, like, badmouthed his movie.
Will Smith.
Yeah.
Or yeah, I like Will Smith.
Jared Leto.
So I'm gonna go to all the Chaos Emeralds.
Yeah, man.
Alright, you ready for this, my man?
Yeah, I'm ready.
This episode is all about S's. Suicide Squad, Supersonic. Pretty cool, huh?
I was yawning, so I couldn't respond, but...
Alright. The crap thing is, I have this stupid bubble, so I gotta get rid of this.
So...
Dude, are you ready for your mind to be blown?
And Saiyan. We're going Super Saiyan. Yeah. Supersonic, Saiyan, Suicide Squad.
Yeah. Alright.
Dude, nice. So can we just turn Super Saiyan anytime we want now?
Yeah, we gotta collect 50 rings, though.
Oh, that's easy. You got 76.
I'm so glad we, got Supersonic by the end of the session.
And then
lose this bubble, man.
So if we get 100 rings and turn Supersonic, we get the maximum amount of time.
Yeah, you can keep collecting rings as well.
Cool.
I think I just did a loop. I think I'm being weird.
Oh. I want to see Supersonic Saiyan.
Yeah, I'm trying to get rid of this stupid bubble.
How do you get rid of it?
Boom.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, it's totally Supersonic.
Yeah, man.
Check Super Saiyan. Do you reckon, which one do you reckon came up first? Do you reckon
Goku, 100%.
They've literally ripped off.
Yeah, I think it was, I've got a feeling it's supposed to be like a bit of a joke.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like a bit of like a nod.
Nod to it.
The fact that it's called Supersonic as well, and he's yellow, he's got spiky hair.
And he flies like a Dragon Ball Z character?
Yeah. Exactly. Brent, yeah, powered up like it. Blonde,
dude, green
eyes.
You know what I'm thinking of right now?
What?
Thinking of that moment where Goku turned Super Saiyan against Frieza on Namek.
I lost it
when that happened.
That was amazing.
Before school, man.
Yeah, dude. I think that moment and when Trunks turns up and kills Frieza.
Oh, dude.
That was epic.
When I love how like effortless that was, like it blew my mind.
Yeah.
I was like, holy crap, like
we just spent like a month trying to kill Frieza.
And he just kills him in like
and then in one episode.
Yep.
Yeah.
There's some pretty good moments. Oh dude, when Gohan's fighting Cell and he's got the one injured arm, so he's like holding his arm.
One hand Kamehameha.
Yeah.
Oh my
dude,
gosh.
So good, man.
Yeah, dude.
There's a
rad battle between Trunks and Goten.
Yeah.
At the like the games?
Yeah.
Not the Cell games, like the World Tournament or whatever. Man, that is a cool fight. It's just them those two just fighting in the arena.
Yeah.
Man, cool. It's so good.
Dude, you know what else was a really cool moment in Dragon Ball Z?
What?
When Majin Vegeta is fighting Goku and you think it's like an even fight with upper hand to margin Vegeta, yeah. and then at the end Goku's like, alright, I don't have time anymore.
Yep. Dude.
And he's like,
Vegeta's pride, just, hey. Yeah. Like in that moment.
But Goku is such a nice guy that he was like, I knew that his pride would be like shot, so yeah. I just pretended I couldn't beat him.
Did you watch GT?
Nah, I tried to.
It's terrible.
I tried. As soon as I got a bit of a taste of what Gohan's character was gonna be,
yeah,
I kind of was like, nah.
Like Gohan's character?
Yeah, yeah, Gohan. I loved Gohan, man.
Dude, Gohan was the man. It was, yeah. So I didn't mind it. Like that's some cool. Definitely some cool moments, but like, I think it was the way they treated the Super Saiyan 4. It got to the point where like, he was just like, poof, there'd be a puff of smoke and then he'd be Super Saiyan 4.
Yeah.
Compared to like how he used to power up. Like the Super Saiyan 3 used to drain him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But then like Super Saiyan 4 is just like, poof.
Yeah.
And he's like,
There was a lot of like, but I think GT wasn't canon necessarily, right?
Yeah,
like,
that's a good point.
I just hated how Gohan was such a weakling in, like in GT, but did they ever explain why Goku turned back into an adult when he was Super Saiyan 4?
Why he turned back to an adult?
Yeah, I think it might have explained. And then when you go Super Saiyan 4, he's an adult.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Was he an adult when he went Super Saiyan the other Super Saiyans?
Yeah.
He was?
Yeah, he was.
He just was an adult for some reason.
Yeah, that's a really good question. I think they might have explained it.
Even though the kid?
Yeah.
Other kids don't turn adult when they go Super Saiyan.
That's a good point. Yeah, no, it was something to do with his tail. Because he grew his tail back.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, there's some connection.
Okay, sure.
Anyway, we should probably...
Look, we're doing pretty well, I think.
Probably close it up.
Yeah, let's close
it. Probably halfway through this level.
Look, that's good. Can you save mid-level in Sonic?
No, I can't.
Like, do you want to finish a level, I guess?
Yeah, we could try.
How long?
It might be kind of long.
Too long?
But it might not be too bad now that I'm supersonic.
Okay.
Let's give it a crack.
Yeah, we can try.
That's it. 17 minutes. So we're going to finish this in 3 minutes.
Yeah, look.
I doubt it, but...
Exactly 20-minute episode. Oh. That'd be great.
Oh, he's so fast.
At least the water's gone.
Oh, see, the thing is, you can still get squashed, like, if you just...
Yeah, sure.
Do the wrong move.
Hey Jav,
my man.
We're playing a show together.
Oh yeah, dude.
On the 21st. It's been a long time.
21st of
21st of August. What's the date today? 10th of August.
10th of August.
Yeah.
We gotta find a bass player.
We gotta find a bass player.
I've never done that before.
Because our other bass player, our usual ring in, is in Turkey right now.
See how I get squashed. So Dave, what's the name of the band?
So it's Game River.
Why'd you call it that?
Because I named it after the river, in Ocarina of Time. Zora's River.
Yeah.
Because Zora's River isn't a game. The Game River.
The Game River.
And no one will ever know.
Except everyone that listened to this episode.
Yeah, well.
Because it's public now for everyone to listen to.
Damn it. All my secrets revealed. It's like, that show where the magician showed you all the secrets.
Oh, yeah.
But better.
Man, I'm actually really excited. It's been a while since I played a show.
Yeah, me too, man. I was just talking about this the other day, but, like, it used to be such a regular part of our lives. Like, we would play shows. I mean, together we would play shows really, really regularly, like...
At least once a fortnight.
Yeah, like, it was crazy, but...
At minimum.
Like, now, and then I probably last... What would you reckon, like, 2 years? Year and a half?
Yeah, I reckon 2 years.
Like, we haven't really played that many shows. No. I've only probably played in the last... In the last year, I think I've only played, like... 7 or 8 shows.
For real.
And they've all mostly... I think they've all just been just me and an acoustic.
Mm.
Which is weird. Like, it doesn't... That's not really normal. This is abnormal.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. And I think abnormal compared to the trajectory our lives were in 2 years ago.
Oh, definitely.
I think that's the way to put it is like,
yeah, yeah.
We play music all the time. We're pushing really hard.
Yeah.
Now we're just like,
we just stopped really. And it was a really sudden stop as well.
Yeah.
But it's cool. Like, I'm looking forward to playing again, man.
Yeah, dude. It'd
be
seriously
cool.
Seriously. I'm looking forward to playing folky stuff again.
Oh, dude. Me too.
My voice is like, it's letting go.
Yeah. Too much air pushed through.
Too much air coming out from my lungs.
Too much.
My vocal box resonates.
Too much tension on them strings. Them
tension
vocal
on
strings.
Them strings.
Tension on them strings.
Get them.
Well, are we nearly finished the episode?
Yeah, I think we're pretty close. We've got this little area.
Yeah.
And then
oof,
the boss.
That is hurting my stomach.
Yeah, I think we're pretty close. I think this is it here.
Yeah, cool, man.
Oh, no, maybe not. One more section.
It'd be cool if you fought the boss supersonic style.
Yeah, I'm gonna get there super quick. Bam, bam, bam.
Dude, what are with these balloons?
Oh, I don't. Oh, that gives us 50 rings. Yay.
Sick.
Let's drop down.
That's awesome. Just stay supersonic.
It's definitely fun. You definitely feel powerful.
That's cool. That's what you want, right?
Yeah. Yeah, here we go.
Yeah, man. Good ring collection.
Nice.
So much speed.
So much
speed. I'd be intimidated if I was that redhead guy.
Do you know his name?
Did we say it already?
I don't think so.
Is it Ranga?
No, what? Renshin? What was your name?
Regina. Hey, we made it.
His name is James.
Really? No way, his name is James.
Isn't it?
No. What? I don't know. Are you being serious?
No, his name's Knuckles.
Oh, Knuckles.
Yeah.
I know Knuckles.
Wait.
What are you doing?
Oh, that's right. I forgot that it does work.
All right, well, man, we did it. We're an ice cap. We're skiing now. Oh, we're boring.
You take the controller.
All right, I'm taking it, guys.
He's doing it. This is David.
Oh, God.
What are you going to do, man?
I don't know.
It's going so fast. Oh, so fast.
Are you serious? Am I meant to do something right now?
Oh, Dave.
Are you serious?
What the heck?
This is the worst.
No, that's good, man. That's what's supposed to happen. All right, before we get into this crazy level, let's call it a night and we can go to bed.
All right, I'm ready for bed.
All right.
See you guys.
See you guys later. I love you.
Love you. Come over later.